A sadhu described above is a devotee of the Lord. His concern, therefore, is to enlighten people in devotional service to the Lord. That is his mercy. He knows that without devotional service to the Lord, human life is spoiled. A devotee travels all over the country from door to door preaching, "Be Krishna conscious. Be a devotee of Lord Krishna. Don't spoil your life in simply fulfilling your animal propensities. Human life is meant for self-realization or Krishna consciousness." These are the preachings of a sadhu. He is not satisfied with his own liberation. He always thinks about others. He is the most compassionate personality towards all the fallen souls. One of his qualifications, therefore, is Karunika, great mercy to the fallen souls. While engaged in preaching work, he has to meet with so many opposing elements. And therefore, the sadhu or devotee of the Lord has to be very tolerant. Someone may ill-treat him because the conditioned souls are not prepared to receive the transcendental knowledge of devotional service. They do not like it. That is their disease. The sadhu has the thankless task of impressing upon them the importance of devotional service. Sometimes devotees are personally attacked with violence. Lord Jesus Christ was crucified. Haridas Thakura was caned in 22 marketplace. And Lord Chaitanya's personal assistant Nityananda was violently attacked by Jagai and Madai. But still they were tolerant because their mission was to deliver the fallen souls. One of the qualifications of a sadhu is that he is very tolerant and is merciful to all fallen souls. He is merciful because he is a well-wisher of all living entities. He is not only well-wisher of the human society, but a well-wisher of animal society as well. It is said here, Sarvadeinam, which indicates all living entities who have accepted material bodies. Not only does the human being have a material body, but other living entities such as cats, dogs also have material body. The devotee of the Lord is merciful to everyone, the cats, dogs, trees, etc. He treats all living entities in such a way that they can ultimately get salvation from this material entanglement. Shivananda Sena, one of the disciples of Lord Chaitanya, gave liberation to a dog by treating the dog transcendentally. There are many instances where a dog got salvation by association with a sadhu. Because a sadhu engages in the highest philanthropic activities for the benediction of all living entities. Yet, although a sadhu is not inimical towards anyone, the world is so ungrateful that even a sadhu has many enemies. What is the difference between an enemy and a friend? It is a difference in behavior. A sadhu behaves with all conditioned souls for their ultimate relief from material entanglement. Therefore, no one can be more friendly than a sadhu in relieving a conditioned soul. A sadhu is calm and is quietly peaceful, follows the principles of scripture. A sadhu means one who follows the principles of scripture and at the same time is a devotee of Lord. One who actually follows the principle of scripture must be a devotee of God, because all the Shastra instruct us to obey the orders of the personality of Godhead. Sadhu therefore means a follower of the scriptural injunction and a devotee of the Lord. All these characteristics are prominent in a devotee. A devotee develops all the good qualities of the demigod, whereas a non-devotee, even though academically qualified, has no actual good qualification or good characteristics according to the standard of transcendental realization. So in this chapter we are saying Lord Kapila is instructing Devahuti about the glories of devotional service. In the last verse we saw, the translation is, text 20, every learned man knows very well that attachment for the material is the greatest entanglement of the spirit soul. So attachment to the material things is the greatest entanglement for the spirit soul. But that same attachment, when applied to the self-realized devotees, opens the door of liberation. So all of us have got attachment. So we have to transfer this attachment to the self-realized devotees, pure devotees like Srila Prabhupada, which opens the door of liberation. So there are always two paths. One, opening the door of liberation. Another one is opening the door of hell. So we have always got the choice. We have to choose among them whether we want to serve Krishna through devotional service or we want to serve Maya. There is no third option actually. So when we are serving Maya, actually our life becomes conditioned. We are conditioned. Just like we will come under the influence of the three modes of material nature. But when we are serving a pure devotee, we will get liberated. That's what actually last verse also Prabhupada quotes about Arisabhadev's verse. Door of liberation is open. So we understand from Bhagavad Gita that we are all soul, we are all atma, and we are engaged in this material body and taking on different bodies, different dresses according to our different activities. Correct? Karanam guna sangasya. According to different guna we associate with, we get different types of body. So a devotee, like sadhu is mentioned, qualities of sadhu. So we can see all these qualities. Just like in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is explaining about 26 qualities. Like that, there are many other qualities also mentioned in the scriptures, in Nectar of Devotion and all. So if you see in a pure devotee's life, you can see all these qualities are embodiment. If you take Prabhupada for example, he was very tolerant, he was very merciful, very compassionate. Like in the today's purport, Prabhupada is writing, human life is meant for self-realization or Krishna consciousness. These are the preachings of a sadhu. He is not satisfied with his own liberation. He always thinks about others. Srila Prabhupada was very well situated, 70-year-old man. He was in Vrindavan. He was writing books. He was chanting. He was absorbed in spreading. He was absorbed always in Krishna consciousness. But at the back of the mind, he was always carrying the instruction of his spiritual master, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakura, who ordered him, who instructed him to go to the West and preach the message to others. So we know how Prabhupada has to undergo a lot of difficulties. Externally, he has to face a lot of troubles. He, to get his visa, we know, he was waiting outside India Steamship Company for 5 hours actually. 70-year-old man, you just imagine. Today we don't have that much patience and all. We go, something is not there, we just walk off. But Prabhupada was not like that. He was so determined. And finally we know how we got visa and how we traveled in that Jaladuta ship, that voyage of compassion we are singing last month and all. So much hardship Prabhupada took. Why? Because a pure devotee can see others are suffering in this world due to lack of Krishna consciousness. That is the only shortage in this material world. Particularly today we have so much advance in science, technology, everything we have. But actually we don't have this God consciousness. And because of that, people are suffering in this world. So a pure devotee, he's not only bothered about his own liberation. He is always, Prabhupada writes here, he always thinks about others. He is most compassionate personality toward the fallen souls. See, we are all so fallen. Somehow by the mercy of Prabhupada, at least we have got this transcendental knowledge. We have come in touch. How we are going to develop this, how we are going to cultivate it, it is in our hand. But at least we got an opportunity to come in touch with this great transcendental knowledge. So, when we give up this body, we all know we take on to another body. So it is not in our hand. We cannot choose. Prabhupada said, I want to be born in a rich Rockefeller's family or Ford family or I want to be born in America. No. Karmana, Daivanetrena, under the higher authorities, we get another body. So this human life is meant for, Prabhupada's idea is for self-realization or becoming Krishna consciousness. This is again and again brought out in the Vedic literature. But otherwise, we'll miss out this very important thing in our life. We are all caught up in so many things, but we'll miss out this. So that's why the Vedic literature brings out this again and again. So Prabhupada says, if you see whole world, it's all divided into different classes. There are always different classes of people. There are some intellectual class, there are some administrative class. So it is according to guna karma vibhagasha. Chaturvarnyam maya system guna karma vibhagasha. Guna is mode or qualities what we acquire. Guna karma and activity or work we are doing. And vibhagasha it is divided into. So all of us can acquire this qualification. Just like Prabhupada said, there is a medical association, or you take lawyers association, or like engineers association. They're all coming from different background, correct? Not a particular family or so. Because they acquired that particular qualification, actually they are called as a doctor or a lawyer or an engineer like that. Similarly, in the Bhagavatam, it is mentioned, in the 7th canto, Yasya yal lakshanam proktam pumso varnabhivya anjakam yad anyatrapi drashyeta tattenayata vinishayet. If one shows the symptom of being a brahmana, kshatriya, or a vaishya, or a shudra, as described above, even if he has appeared in different class, he should be accepted according to the symptom of this classification. So, just like in the Bhagavatam itself, we have about Rishabhadev. Rishabhadev has 100 sons. And out of which, Prabhupada said, 9 became Navayogendras. So, balance, some of them became Kshatriyas, some of them became Vaishyas. So, like, it's not by birth. It's by developing that qualities, actually. Qualification. So, that is the thing. So, Prabhupada in one lecture, he mentioned that human life is meant for stopping this repetitive birth and death. This punarjanma is actually a torture. That's why today's modern world, people don't talk about all these things. Because if you have accountable for your future life means, you have to act in a particular way. So they are all brushing aside and going on with so-called false material enjoyment. That's why Prabhupada mentioned in a lecture about Vishwamitra Muni, when he approached Dasharath Maharaj. The Vishwamitra Muni was doing meditation in the forest, because the sages, these brahmanas, they used to go to forest to meditate. They meditate on Lord Vishnu so that to achieve perfection. And when they are there in the forest, always there is some rakshasas coming and disturbing them, demon coming and disturbing them. So he approached Dasharath Maharaj and he asked him, I would like to take your son, both Rama and Lakshmana, to kill a demon in the forest. So the moment Dasharath Maharaj received Vishwamitra Muni, he greeted with saying, Haishtam yat tat punar janma jayaya. That is, what you have done for conquering your birth and death. That's why they used to greet. Just like Prabhupada gives the example, you meet a businessman, you meet a friend, you ask him, how is your business going on, what is your profit, what is your top level, what is your bottom line, all these things we ask, correct? Similarly, if you ask a sage, we have to inquire about how we can stop this repetition of birth and death. Because we know this material body is a suffering, is a place of suffering. This material world is a place of suffering. And if you don't make solution, you are again transferred into the womb of another mother. Again, you go on taking birth. So we have to look into this thing. Aim of human life, Prabhupada in another place says, he says, it is possible for us to understand what is the ultimate goal of life. It is samsidhir haritoshanam. We have to satisfy Hari or Krishna. That should be the goal of life. So whole varna and ashrama is divided into such thing so that people can gradually advance and ultimately they can reach the goal of life. So similarly, we can satisfy Lord Shri Krishna with our talent. It's not that we have to acquire something externally. All of us have got some intelligence, we have got some talent. We have to use this talent in the service of the Lord and spreading the Lord's mission actually. So every one of us can be engaged in the service of the Lord. That's why Prabhupada said, created this ISKCON, Hare Krishna movement, with that sole purpose. Giving an opportunity for people to hear about Krishna, hear Krishna's glories, associate with devotees. So it's a very nice opportunity. Otherwise, see, in the city, busy city like this, people are getting ready in the morning, correct? They have to go to work play, they have to go to different occupation, different duty they have to do. Whereas, see, few fortunate, because of Prabhupada's mercy, we got this opportunity. Actually, we are able to sit and try to understand from the scriptures. So, we have to take this advantage. Everything is available in abundance. We have to take this advantage and achieve the highest perfection of life to get liberation, even going back home, back to God. That's why Krishna says, Manmanabha madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. Very simple instruction Krishna has given. Always think of me. Become my devotee. Worship me. Pay obeisances unto me. So just by doing these four things, actually we can go to Krishna Loka. Krishna is assuring in the Bhagavad Gita. So this is a very nice opportunity we have been provided. Prabhupada mentions in a lecture about how when he wanted to set up a temple in Bombay in the early 70s. By then ISKCON was well established, we all know. And he had a lot of difficulties, troubles to getting municipalities, persons, they are coming and harassing, police people are coming and harassing him. And you know, the tenants who are staying there, they are not vacating. And the landowner who, you know, Mr. Nair, the famous conversation is there, he agreed to give Prabhupada this land. Then finally, when he got a better offer, he actually denied, he didn't want to give. Like that. So Prabhupada has to face a lot of difficulties, challenges. Prabhupada says in that lecture, we could have easily walked away from Bombay. Already I had established more than 100 temples. What is this one? No, but Prabhupada was very merciful, very compassionate. We know how Prabhupada, he went to big cities in America. And he wanted to give this philosophy of Krishna consciousness. Like Prabhupada says, once a reporter asked, why Swamiji you have come off all the place to New York? New York is considered to be a capital of finance market there in America. So Prabhupada said, I got the best philosophy. I want to give to the best city in the world. Like that, Prabhupada's vision was like this. So we know how with a lot of hardship and shifting the deities, Radha Rasbihari in a small tent, like that, worship started, and finally we know Bombay temple was built, and Prabhupada had another total 5 temples in India. And main thing is, Prabhupada says that these people are engaged in sense gratification. They're just enjoying their senses, that's all. So for preaching purpose, this is very important actually. That's why we know Prabhupada was somewhere in the West also. He used to get, he always wanted to get information about the Bombay Temple construction. A lot of hardship were there because all these Westerners, few Westerners were dealing with those days. In the early days, not many Indians had joined. So Prabhupada was very concerned, and we know how the temple got inaugurated and it laid a foundation for our Indian preaching movement also. So today also, a lot of people, today you see in India, so much momentum is there because Prabhupada, he built that one temple. Similarly, he went to Russia and he just met that Professor Kotowski. Those days it was not open. It was very tough to preach. Somehow he managed and today you see all over the world like that Prabhupada is traveling. Why? Because Sudha, he was thinking for the welfare of others. How a man, Prabhupada says, how a man can be saved from the clutches of Maya. We are all under the tight grip of Maya. And like Prabhupada is writing in the purport also, we are not interested actually. We are not interested in this transcendent. Because the conditioned souls are not prepared to receive the transcendental knowledge of devotional service. They do not like it. That is their disease. The sadhu has a thankless task of impressing upon the importance of devotional service. So sadhu, a devotee, has a thankless job because he is the well-wisher of all living entity. Just like Prabhupada gives the example of the United Nations organization, correct? UNO. They all discuss about how to solve the problems of the human being. But here this verse says, Sudham Sarvadeinam. Sarvadeinam, Prabhupada translates as to all living entities, not only human being. So they talk of human being, and if you see during their lunch time and their breakfast time and dinner time, they all indulge in enjoying non-vegetarian food actually. They are not caring about other living entities actually. That is not. So they are talking a big thing. We have to become united. We have to be. It's a nationalism. This is the philosophy they generate actually. Human being. So what is the meaning of national? Prabhupada says, a person who is born in a particular place, he's got a national. Just like we are all born in India, we are called Indian. We get a certificate. We are all Indian. Similarly, somebody is born in America, he's called American. Not only human being, even the cow, dogs, cats, anybody who is born in India is a national, Indian national. So you are taking class of one class of human being and you are sending other living entity to a slaughterhouse. This is not fair, actually. So this is happening because they are not having this transcendental knowledge, nor they are interested in this knowledge. So a devotee, that's what a preacher has to go and infuse this Krishna consciousness to others. Just like all of us will be familiar with this story about a hunter. How he was going on killing recklessly. Animal half dead. And somehow Narada Muni meets him and he's asking, why you are killing this animal half? Why don't you kill them full? Full dead. So he was enjoying that. Because he said, that is my profession, what to do? My father was also a hunter, I am also a hunter like that. So, because he came in touch with Narada Muni, actually he became a devotee, he became a Vaishnava. Later on, when Narada Muni and Parvata Muni is coming to see, from the long distance when he saw his spiritual master, so the hunter was told, so what I'll do with my daily living? This is my profession. Unfortunately, what? So you are telling about karma. You don't know about karma. You will get a lot of sinful reaction. You have to suffer all these things. Then what to do? You give me some alternate profession. So he was asked to sit on the bank of the Ganges. And he was given a tulsi plant. He was telling, just worship Tulsi Maharani. And next day, in the morning, he gets lots and lots of footsteps. People are sending. Because the message has reached that a hunter has become a devotee of Lord. So, Lord, everybody, because if you come and if you want to come and see a sadhu, a devotee, generally we take something, correct? That is our anyway culture. So, lot of things he got. So, you are thinking, why Narada Muni is sending so many things like this? So, later on, we know how Narada Muni and Parvata Muni's friend, they had come. And this hunter who has become now a devotee from the long distance he saw, and he is about to pay obeisances. But they noticed that he was walking, not properly actually. He was jumping here and there. So, Narada Muni inquired, why are you okay? You are coming here, why are you? So, he is saying, I see a lot of ants. I don't want to step on ants also. So, if somebody becomes a devotee, that's why Prabhupada, at the end of the purport also, he says, in the Bhagavatam, there's a verse, it says, a devotee develops all the good qualities of the demigod. Whereas a non-devotee, even though academically qualified, has no qualification, has no good qualification or good characteristics according to the standard of transcendental realization. Esyasta bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvai gunai tatta samaste sura. Even the qualities of a demigod, actually a devotee will possess. But at the same time, Prabhupada said, but when we start preaching, devotees don't have any enemies, but yes, we have no enemy, but we know others become inimical towards us. Others become our enemy. So what to do? We have to tolerate. So that is also one of the quality mentioned, titikshava. We have to tolerate and go on preaching this Krishna consciousness. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also said, tinadapi sunichena tarorapi saishna amanina manadina kirtaniya sadari. We have to be more tolerant than a tree. Then only we can constantly chant the glories of the holy name. So these qualities we have to try to develop. But simply by becoming a devotee of Lord Krishna, serving a pure devotee like Prabhupada, all this will come automatically. So we should have faith in the scriptures and we should follow the process. Then we can get this quality. We know how Prahlad Maharaj was put into so many difficulties by his own father actually, Hiranyakashipu. He was a young boy, 5-year-old boy. What was his mistake? What was his fault? He was trying to be a devotee of Lord Vishnu. He was a devotee of Lord Vishnu right from the birth. And for that, he has to face so many challenges. But Prahlad Maharaj was not deterred. He was so determined. He knows, my Lord will protect me always. He will take care of me always. So he was continuing like that. And finally we know how Prahlad Maharaj, his father became so against him. He tried to kill him. Then at that time, Lord Narasimha appeared and killed his father, Hiranyakashipu. So that point of time, after that, Lord Narasimha Deva is asking Prahlad, why so much, you have taken so much tapasya, so much hardship. Oh, any benediction you want. So what did Prahlad ask? Any benediction? What did Prahlad ask? He asked, you please deliver my father. Because I know he was against you and he created so much inconvenience. So that is a devotee, quality of a devotee. He is not wanting anything for himself, but he is concerned about others. So Lord Narasimha Dev says, not only your father, 21 generation, Bhagavatam says, 21 generation of your forefathers are delivered just because you are born in the family, you are born in that family. So this is the best service we can do to our forefathers and all. If we try to become a devotee, actually we will be delivered and others can also be delivered. That's why Prabhupada writes, this is the best philanthropic work one can think of in this. And like that, Prabhupada also gives the example of how Jesus Christ, Haridas Thakur, and Nityananda Prabhu. Jesus Christ was preaching the gospel of God. Same thing. So he was crucified. Haridas Thakur was caned in 21-22 marketplace. Nityananda, who is the Supreme Lord, the Chaitanya's expansion, Nityananda Prabhu, he was also attacked by Jagai and Madai. But they were not perturbed. They tolerated. Because anybody who commit an offense towards a pure devotee, actually they are doomed, actually. But they are so merciful to deliver them, they took all these troubles. And ultimately we know how all of them were saved. And Prabhupada also in the purport mentions about Shivananda Sena, how he delivered a dog. So devotees are always trying to be compassionate. He is very merciful. We have got something very precious. We want to pass it on to others. So that is the preaching work of Krishna consciousness movement. Not that we have been benefited. We'll just do our own bhajana. Not like that. So it's a very nice thing. These qualities are mentioned. Prabhupada, if you see in the folio, there are close to 100 hits are there. Prabhupada in many places, he writes about this verse from the Bhagavatam. Because these qualities can be found only in the devotees. So like that, we'll read further about the different qualities Bhagavatam explained thoroughly in the coming verse. So I'll stop here. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki.